Hey.
Courtney said you wanted to see me.
Yeah. Can you give this to Bobby?
It's kind of hard to figure out what to write, how to put my feelings down. You know, how do you say thank you, goodbye? And now you're standing here in front of me, and I'm not sure what to say.
And you don't have to say anything.
You know that, how I feel, right? You know, you've been everything. I know that you have been everything
Carly,
to me, and
Carly, Carly, I understand, it's okay. You know that the first thing that, that you ever gave me was a keychain with my name on it, and, a year later, I gave one to you. But we can't do that stuff now because it can be traced. So, I got you this from the airport in Paris. I know it's a tourist junk, and there are millions like it. So I just, you know, I want you to keep this. To remember me by, okay?
What am I gonna do if you're not there to catch me when I fall?
I trust you. Now you need to trust yourself.
What if I can't?
Just call me. I will come and get you. No matter what.
Favor, will you? Tell Mike that actually don't tell him anything because he'll just take it the wrong way.
Don't take this the wrong way, but you know something, you're not the easiest person to love. You know, Mike hasn't quite figured out how to manage it. You know, he says the wrong thing, you take it the wrong way. The past gets dragged up and you know what gets lost? How much you two really mean to each other.
How come you know so much?
I'll tell her, Dad, how much you love him.
I love you, too. I know I haven't always been the best brother.
You
know,
you have. In your own way.
You sure did stand up to me a few times.
Yeah, well, I guess we both found out that neither of us likes to be pushed around.
Yeah, I was just, you know, I was just trying to look out for you.
I know. You know, I didn't realize it at first, but I needed you so much. And you're the brother I always wanted.
Watch my
eye. Oh, Daddy! Courtney!
Hey, what's up, partner?
Courtney, why are you crying?
Oh, it's just the cold air making my eyes water.
Michael felt cooped up in the room, so he wanted to take a walk.
Come with us.
Yeah, it's probably a little cold for Morgan. We'll wait back in the room.
You sure?
Yeah, I can spend some time with her.
Watch my...
Watch your arm.
It's just that I sort of...
Will Santa still find us in our new house?
Of course he will.
But I'll have a new name. What if he doesn't know who I am?
You know what? Hey. There were so many times that I thought you, for sure, you were not going to be born. But here you are, my beautiful son. I want to see your face every day.
I want to see you grow. I want to see you take your first step. Start school. Yeah. You know, I always promised that I was going to be a good father. You know? The kind of father that my sons can look up to and respect, huh? Yeah? You shouldn't have to pay for my choice, right? I have to face what I've done. Poppy has to face what he's done, right? Set an example for you, Michael. You don't run, you don't hide. And one day, if I survive, you may come to me and ask me why I chose what I did. And I'm gonna have to answer you honestly. Huh? I am going back. Not because of pride, but because I love you all.
Mr. Corinto said he had to go home to settle some unfinished business.
I need to get on that first flight.
The best thing for you to do is wait.
I need to testify for Sonny.
It's too risky.
Jason, the jury needs to know that Sonny was set up by Alcazar. The police were waiting there to ambush him. If he's gonna fight this, I'm gonna fight with him.
What did Mrs. Corinto say when she called to warn you, Mr. Alcazar?
She asked me to leave town. She said her husband was coming to kill me.
Objection. This testimony contradicts Mr. Alcazar's original statement, where he claimed Mrs. Corinthos said his life was in danger. He never used the word kill.
Redirect the question, please.
Yes, Your Honor. Yes, Your Honor. Did Mrs. Corinthos specifically say that her husband would try to kill you, Mr. Alcazar?
That's my recollection.
Thank you. What happened next?
I called the police.
And what did the police tell you?
I'll take it from here. Mr. Alcazar, during your conversations with the police, did you ever agree to lure Mr. Corinthos to his building? Did you ever goad him into firing his gun?
No.
Did you set Mr. Corinthos up, or did you conspire with the police to entrap him?
No, I didn't.
Sorry to interrupt, Your Honor. I understand I'm on trial for attempted murder. I just thought I should be here to see it.
How much do you...
Did you set Mr. Corinthos up? Did you conspire with the police to entrap him?
No, I didn't.
Sorry to interrupt, Your Honor. I understand I'm on trial for attempted murder. I just thought I should be here to see it.
Mr. Corinthos, how nice that you could fit us into your schedule after all. Please, have a seat.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Better late than never. Going back to stand trial, let's sway the jury in our favor.
And if you think I'm just going to sit here and be silent, you're wrong. I'm taking the damn stand.
He's an old saying. The man who represents himself has a fool for a client. The same holds true for a defendant who takes a stand. It's a bad idea, Sonny. You're too...
Guilty. Is that what you're trying to tell me? Is that what you're
emotionally
trying?
Involved. Cross-examination is tricky by definition. You could be led into saying something that's damaging to our case.
We're waiting, Mr. Ward.
I apologize, Your Honor. The defense requests a recess so that I might have time to confer with my client.
I have no objection with that, as long as he says his piece from his tight holding cell.
Your request is denied. This trial is already in progress. The defendant's delay in appearing will not alter its course. Continue with your witness, Mr. Baldwin.
Thank you, Your Honor. I'd like to get back to how you knew that the defendant was on his way to kill you.
I object.
I'll rephrase. You had warning, is that correct?
Yes.
Who gave you warning?
Mrs. Corentos.
Does that strike you as a little odd?
No.
The defendant's own wife warning you. That's perfectly natural behavior.
I believe she did it out of love for me.
Do you still believe that your life is in danger?
If Sonny Corentos is released, he'll make an attempt to kill me within 48 hours.
Dead within 48 hours. No further questions.
Your witness, counselor. You kidnapped the defendant's wife, is that correct?
Objection, Your Honor. Irrelevant.
Foundation. It was while holding the defendant's wife hostage that this witness developed his obsession for her.
I'll allow it.
Once Mrs. Corentos was reunited with her husband, did you wish her well and go on your way?
I've always wished her well.
That's not an answer. Did you respect the defendant's marriage and leave his wife alone?
No.
You sent flowers?
Yes.
Gifts?
Yes.
In fact, you openly stated your intention to have Mrs. Corentos for yourself.
Yes, I did.
And you would have gone to any extreme to make this happen?
Yes.
Up to and including making a woman over to look like Mr. Corentos' dead wife, Lily.
That's right.
For what purpose, Mr. Alcazar?
To unsettle Mr. Corentos enough to leave his wife.
Giving you clear field to hold Mrs. Corentos hostage.
I never forced Carly to return my love.
I have no further questions for this witness.
You may step down.
And I am not finished. My intention was never to take Carly against her will or harm her in any way, unlike her husband who put a bullet in her head and sent her into a coma.
That's enough, Mr. Alcazar. You're out of order. You are instructed to disregard this witness's outburst. Step down. Call your next witness, Mr. Baldwin.
Prosecution calls. Carly Corentos. Raise your right hand. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Be seated. Are you nervous, Mrs. Corentos?
I'm fine.
Let me get you a glass of water.
I said I'm fine.
Your Honor.
Move along, Mr. Baldwin.
The night in question, prior to the shooting, you're with the defendant.
That's correct.
Where were you?
My husband owns an island near Puerto Rico.
His own island? Wow! He must make a lot of money
in
the coffee
business. Objection, Your Honor. You want to talk about irrelevant?
Sustained.
Sorry, Your Honor. It's a lovely picture. Husband and wife reunited on their own private island. But you weren't there for romantic reasons.
I don't understand your question.
You were there to patch things up. Their marital problems, right?
We were there because I had just been released from the hospital.
But there were problems. What were they?
Objection, leading the witness.
Sustained.
On the night Sonny left to go back to Port Charles, did he tell you that he was going after Alcazar?
No.
You knew it.
I thought it might be possible.
Thought? Was it like a thought like this boom went through your head, or did you... You really were concerned, weren't you?
Look, I don't like not knowing where my husband is. I think that any wife understands...
So concerned that you picked up the phone and you called Alcazar to warn him that Sonny was on his way. It's public record.
Yes.
What was this drive to warn Alcazar? What was it based on?
Sonny had
had a feeling that Alcazar might be a threat.
Did you give him reason to feel threatened?
No. No, I said something irrational, something that... an idea of a dream that I had when I was comatose.
Yeah, but it must have been real enough to him because, I mean, he went off to murder another man.
Objection. Calls for conclusion.
Sustained.
All right, let me offer this possible scenario and see if it has any merit whatsoever. You warned Lorenzo Alcazar because you have feelings for him. You wanted to protect him.
No, I wanted to protect Sonny. I told Lorenzo to leave town, but he didn't. I didn't want any of this to happen.
Now, let me, come on. Do you or do you not have feelings for Lorenzo Alcazar?
I don't know.
Do you have any doubt that had you not warned Lorenzo Alcazar about Sonny, that he would be dead right now? Do you want me to repeat the question?
No.
Answer the question, Mrs. Corinthos.
Your husband went after Alcazar, and had you not stepped in, he would be dead.
Objection.
Is that
true? Conjecture on the part of the witness.
Sustain. Wrap this up, Mr. Baldwin.
Why are you here, Mrs. Corinthos?
I am here to testify that my husband was set up. Lorenzo Alcazar called the police and arranged for them to ambush Sonny. It's kind of like what you're doing right now, Scott, railroading him because you have a grudge against him.
And you have a history of bed hopping from one guy's bed to another. How many bastard children do you have around town right now?
Hey, you know what?
Sit down.
That's why your lawyer is telling you to sit down. Sit down. You want to come out with me right now?
Sit down.
You
want
to come out with me?
Your client is dangerously close to contempt.
And the DA is risking a lawsuit.
You've gone too far, Mr. Baldwin. Now, you may consult on this case, but you are not to utter another word in open court. Is that clear? You may cross-examine.
No further questions, Your Honor.
You may step down. Mr. Lansing, call your next witness.
Prosecution calls Michael Sonny Corinthos. What line of work are you in?
Import, export. Half owner of a coffee warehouse.
How does that innocuous occupation get you consistently sitting?
Objection!
I'll rephrase. Mr. Corinthos, isn't it true that Lorenzo Alcazar posed a threat to your import-export business?
No.
So you weren't mad at him for professional reasons?
No.
But you were indeed mad at him because he made it no secret that he was after your wife.
Yes, that's correct.
So you were jealous?
Yeah. I guess you could call it that.
So, Mr. Corinthos, when you left your wife on your island and returned to Port Charles, was it your intention to confront Lorenzo Alcazar?
Yeah.
And for what purpose?
Kill him.
No more questions.
Ward, you may cross-examine.
I have only one question for the witness. Why?
Carly is my wife. She means everything to me. Out of nowhere, this man comes along and he holds her prisoner while she's carrying our child. He has no respect for our marriage. our family. For whatever reason he decides he wants her. This sick individual changes a woman's face to make it look like my dead wife's. And then he uses her to make me doubt my own sanity. I'm gonna tell you what happened now. I walked into our new house. This man was standing over her. She was screaming. I didn't know what was going on. I thought he was hurting her. So I shot him. And the bullet went through him. And it hit my wife. And I looked down. She was having a baby. And I didn't know, you know. So I started delivering the baby. We've been wanting this baby for a long time. And then I looked up and I saw what I had done. What this man had driven me to do. After that, I sat there, helpless, watching the woman that I love fight for her life. And still, this man didn't have the decency to stay away.
Make an objection. He's coming across way too insistent.
Let him finish.
Oh, come on.
After I shot my wife, I promised that I would never fire. Another gun. But this man, this predator, did not stop. It just kept coming and coming. It was like a cancer under our skin. That's why.
You may step down. Call your next witness.
Prosecution rests, Your Honor.
Mr. Ward. Are you ready to begin your defense?
The defense rests. I'm prepared for closing argument.
Very well. Proceed.
You've already heard the best defense. Straight from my client's mouth. The defense of self, of family, and of the woman he loves. I imagine when Sonny took the stand, you expected to hear about gangsters, revenge. Instead, you heard a love story, one I think we can all relate to. It's human nature to fight for what's yours. And the truth is, no one was killed on the night in question, or even hurt. It was a trap. Lorenzo Alcazar was wearing a bulletproof vest, surrounded by police officers laying in wait, hoping the situation would get volatile enough for my client to be killed. Just one more deliberate act on the part of Alcazar to remove Sonny as an obstacle to the ultimate prize, his wife. If you think that kind of effort is worthy of reward, you can send Sonny to jail, give Alcazar what he wants, or you can recognize the truth of what happened that my client was manipulated into being in front of Alcazar's house that night with a gun in his hand. That's entrapment, ladies and gentlemen. There's only one verdict that makes any sense. Not guilty.
My esteemed colleague, Mr. Ward, has told you a very moving story. A story of love and a family. I was very touched by it. But that is not why we are here. We are here because a crime has been committed. Attempted, premeditated murder. Sonny Corinthos left his wife on their island and returned to Port Charles for one reason and one reason only, and that was to kill Lorenzo Alcazar. Now, Mr. Ward's compelling story aside, that's what this case is about. It is up to the 12 of you. You are the final arbiter. You must decide between fact and fiction. But before you do that, I ask you to consider one question. If you acquit Sonny Corinthos today, how are you going to feel in a year, in a month, in a day? If you open up your newspapers, you turn on your television sets, and you see the image of Lorenzo Alcazar being zipped up in a body bag. Sonny Corinthos is guilty of attempted murder. That's all that matters here.
We will reconvene tomorrow morning at 10 a.m. You will receive instructions and then begin deliberations. This court is adjourned.
That jury's been tampered with and gives them an acquittal. I want Corinthos killed.
Hey, wait a
He's in with justice. The jury just went out and they're deliberating. The longer they take, the better it is for us.
Yeah. Well, I heard that Sonny got through to the jury yesterday, so.
Yeah, I hope so.
Hey, you all right?
Yeah, I just definitely need some caffeine, that's all.
Sonny wants to see you.
How is he?
He'll be okay.
You say that like, you know, he just spent last night in hell.
Did you sleep at all last night?
Wasn't that bad?
Sure. And I didn't worry about you all night.
You out of here?
No, I can handle it. I can handle it.
I have an idea.
No.
Listen to me. I'm gonna do this for you, okay? You may seem like a stranger and an incredibly good-looking one. I'm teasing, okay? But I'm gonna do this for you.
No, Cardi, stay out of it.
That sounds familiar. Sonny,
came back on his own to stand trial, won't that help him with the jury?
If it doesn't, I'm already working on the appeal.
Okay, you can forget an appeal. I want Sonny out of here now.
I would if I could.
This is cruel and unusual punishment. I will sue this department for every dime it has.
I'm already working on a harassment suit. It could be months before I could do anything.
So what do I have to do? Justice? You tell me, do I need to get a news crew in here? Because it seems to be the only language that Baldwin speaks.
Oh, hey, listen, Sonny will be out in time for lunch.
And why is that?
Jury has a verdict.
Already?
I'm sorry. Sonny's going to Sing Sing.
You don't know that, Baldwin.
A short deliberation usually means guilty.
Not always.
Listen. You lost. Let's face it, okay, Justice? Your client is going to prison. Justice will be served. I like that. Sonny Corrientos is history. Organized crime in this town as we know it is over.
Have you heard the verdict?
I don't need to hear a verdict. A short deliberation means guilty. He will pay for the crimes that he has committed. The jury is sending a message to me.
Excuse me, you know something? You have a personal vendetta against my son.
Hey, you know what? Your son is a professional criminal, right? He's going to jail and
Yeah, what about Rick Lansing?
What about him?
Why don't you try investigating the assistant DA? Do you know what he did to Carly?
Well, he certainly didn't put a bullet in Carly's head.
No. Lansing kidnapped her and chained her to a wall for weeks.
You know, what Miss Corrientos does with her private life is really none of our business. Now get out of here.
The DA's office is full of criminals, and you, Baldwin, are the number one crook.
You see what I have to deal with here? But I won't let him stop me. I will continue to clean up crime in this town. I will put on a cape, and I will crusade the streets at night if I have to. Now, excuse me. I have a verdict to celebrate.
Where have you been?
Some business.
No contact with the prisoner.
I'll deal with my clients, thank you.
Judge Russell Bragg presiding. You may be seated. This court is now in session.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, have you reached a verdict?
We have, Your Honor.
Count of attempted murder. How do you find?
Not guilty.
On the count of kidnapping, how do you find?
Not guilty.
On the count of reckless endangerment, how do you find?
We find Mr. Corrientos not guilty.
Courtroom. Order in this courtroom.
Your Honor, permission to poll the jury.
Permission granted.
Bobby, sweetheart, turn on the TV. They found him not guilty on all counts. Can you believe it? Yeah, Sonny's on his way home.
Mr. Baldwin, are you satisfied that the verdict is unanimous?
Your Honor, I ask that you vacate the verdict.
I see no reason to overrule this jury.
The verdict is a travesty.
The verdict stands. Members of the jury,
You are excused, and thank you for your invaluable service to this court. Mr. Corinthos, you're free to go.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Court is adjourned.
Oh, did you hear that? I'm free and we can have our lives back.
You did some good work.
That's why you hired me.
What the hell happened?
Sonny knows how to work a jury.
He confessed up on the witness stand for crying out loud.
He did it for love, Scott.
Oh, come on, Lansing. Whose side are you on?
Don't worry. If you can't bring Sonny down, I will.
You guys ready to go?
How does it feel to be a free man?
Mrs. Corinthos, are you happy?
Who told you to kill Corinthos?
We already know who it is.
If he has to say the name, who are you working for?
PCPD, just like you. And if you want to keep your job, detective, you keep your mouth shut.
Just give me a name.
Puppet.
Congratulations.
Yeah.
Well, I know you can do it.
It's like,
it's great.
Yeah. He was great with that jury, wasn't he?
I just told the truth, that's all.
Well, I, for one, am very happy for you, Sonny.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah,
that's
great.
All right.
Thank you very much.
How about a toast?
Thank you.
Here. To my son, Michael. And to family.
Yeah. To family, huh?
And to justice, who finally brought some real justice to this town.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Oh, yeah.
Now another one.
Yeah. Sure. That one.
Okay. All right. So, hey, listen.
What's wrong with that?
Come on, let's get down and have a pretzel. Here, huh? Hey, you. Hey, don't worry. He'll be here, Jason. He'll be here.
Ready?
Am I that obvious?
Good.
You and Jason are going to get back together. I can feel it.
To hope.
Ah, to hope. And to the best friend that I have ever had.
Oh, God, I don't believe it.
What?
Look at that.
I hate him.
Yeah, me too.
But think of it this way. Sonny beat him, so Rick's got to be choking on it.
Congratulations. You beat an open and shut case.
I saw you when I was testifying on the stand. Why didn't you object?
Oh, I just missed.
No grounds.
Since when did that stop the lawyer? You wanted me to hang myself so that way the jury would convict.
I should have known better. You know, I can convince anybody of almost anything, but you had me beat today. Maybe you should have been the lawyer.
You can keep trying to take me down, Rick. Ain't gonna happen.
Okay. You know, Sonny, maybe Rick just appreciates how much you love your wife. Maybe you're the one who's stuck in the past.
Maybe, but I doubt it.
Capelli blew the hit. He's not gonna get another chance to kill Sonny. Neither will you.
Sonny, I already have what he wants. Carly's love. If Sonny's a free man, you're not obligated to stand by him. You can make up your own mind.
There is nothing to decide. There never has been. Everything that you did to me, taking me hostage, following me back here, trying to drive my husband crazy, it was a waste. Because I'm never going to love you, Lorenzo.
Are you sure about that?
Oh, I see. I'm supposed to question how I feel. Is that the idea? Now that you've stolen my life, you want me to doubt my own heart. Guess what? It's not going to happen. Because everything that I felt for you, it was a dream. It was a lie. You were never a history professor. We never shared a life together, and God knows I never loved you, and I don't love you now.
All right, you're angry because I testified.
You don't get to ruin my life. You don't get to steal me from Sonny. I know that I love my husband. I may not feel it in the way that I used to, but I'm going to soon. You do not get to destroy everything that's been precious to me in my life. You just don't...
Hey, what is it?
Back off!
Carter.
You do not get to destroy everything that's been precious to me in my life. You just don't...
Hey, back off!
Carly. Call 911, get an ambulance.
Phone ahead to General Hospital. Her neurosurgeon is Tony Jones.
I'm gonna go with you, okay?
Sir, there's...
Hey, I'm... No,
Sonny.
I'm going...
Sonny, Bobby, and I'll be...
Stay
right
away
by
from the hospital.
Why this happened?
You know why this happened, because you wouldn't leave her alone.
I love Carly. I'm part of her life.
Carly just collapsed. We don't know if she is ever going to wake up again, and all you can think about is how to work it to your advantage. That is not love. It's just sick obsession. Tony's on his way. He's ordered a CAT scan. Let's go.
They say it's a constipation from when I shot.
She's gonna be okay.
You don't know that. What if she's going into another coma?
Well, everything appears normal. It doesn't seem that this episode has anything to do with any kind of complications from her head injury.
Monica, any theory on why this happened?
I don't know. Well, it could have been a mini stroke due to a clot.
When the clot show up on the test?
I don't know, Sonny, really. It could be many things we're not really going to know until she wakes up.
I want to see her.
Okay.
Street in front of Alcazar's apartment, and you were there in the snow. You were about to shoot him.
I love you. I love you. I know that now. I feel it in my heart. I love you, and only you, and I always will.
You looked at me, and I was so happy. And then I woke up. Dear, you are.
Where else would I be? I love you.
Guys, I'm fine, really. Everything's fine. You don't need to fuss.
Just got out of the hospital. We gotta be careful. Yeah.
I'm okay. So you see, I'm walking and I'm talking and everything's fine. Hey. Oh, hey. Hi.
Welcome home.
Just in time for the holidays.
How are you feeling, Carly?
Oh, much better now.
Don't look at me.
Look, Courtney organized the whole thing. All we did was follow instructions.
Well, actually, I brought some eggnog.
Yeah.
And Mike brought some Christmas CD.
Which I'll put on right now.
Mommy, I made for you.
Oh, let's see. Wow.
It's an ornament for the tree. See, it's an angel. She has yellow hair. She's smiling. She's really, really pretty. Just like you, Mommy.
Oh.
Yeah, she is the most beautiful angel I have ever seen.
Wow. You don't have to put her on the tree if you don't want to.
Well, of course I want to put her on the tree. I love that you made her for me. I love you, Mr. Man. What is it?
It's you.
Yeah, of course it's me.
It's you from before. The way you were.
Yeah.
Mommy's back.
Yeah, she's back.
I know you've been worried about me, sweetheart. I've been worried about myself, too, but things are gonna be okay now. I can feel it. I can feel everything.
I don't get it.
I don't blame you, sweetheart. All that matters, though, is that I love you.
Carla, you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay, Mom. Actually, I'm starving. Are there any cookies?
They're in the kitchen. Do you want me to get you some?
Yeah.
Why don't Bobby and I help you, kiddo?
Okay.
Come on.
And I'll love you very much.
I love you too.
On overload.
Yeah, but it's in a good way. I don't just know that this is my life. I can feel it again. I love you both. And you. Sonny, I love you.
Hey.
Hey.
Why'd you let me sleep?
You asked me to.
When?
When I woke up this morning, I asked you if you wanted breakfast in bed, and you kind of rolled over and went back to sleep.
Really? Yeah, because I didn't realize how tired I was.
So I guess you didn't realize when I kind of undressed you.
So that's where my clothes went, huh?
Yeah, I admit it was a little disappointing. I went to give the boys a goodnight kiss, went back into the room. You had your clothes on and kind of rolled over and you passed out, snoring away.
I don't snore.
Well, a little bit, but not enough to bother me.
Because you love me, right? I don't get it, but I was relieved when I woke up and I saw your face and I could feel our love again. I don't know, maybe something just broke free in my head. Maybe, I don't know, it just all came back. You said it would one day.
Yeah. You know, it was very hard to hold on to the faith, because you were right in front of me, and I didn't see the love.
Do you see the love now?
At the corner.
Oh, are you gonna go by yourself?
Max can take me.
Oh.
I gotta give this to Santa.
Let me see.
I don't want to miss the mailman.
Okay, well, let me think about this. You know what? Grandma told me Santa's gonna be at Kelly's. Uh-huh. So, yes, why don't you go on upstairs, tell Letitia to get Morgan dressed, and then we can all go together, okay? Hey, give me this so you don't forget it, right? Safe in our hands.
It's pretty smooth.
You like that? Thank you.
Let's see what he wants.
Yeah, you check that out, and I'll go shopping tomorrow and make sure I get everything on his list.
I don't think you're gonna have to do that.
Why not? Dear Santa, Morgan doesn't need any toys. He's a baby. I don't need any, too, because Mommy's... Okay. Very truly yours, Michael Corinthos III.
Michael's got everything he wants.
Yeah.
So does his father.
Santa's gonna be there all day. Crazy.
I bet you were just like that when you were a kid.
Yeah, it was much worse, actually. I'm coming, okay? How did you manage when I was in the hospital?
Well, Letitia and Courtney were amazing, you know. But the truth is that I wasn't thinking of anything but you.
Ooh. Well, I expect to have the same kind of attention tonight.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey.
Hi, Jason.
Michael's out by the elevator. He looks pretty excited.
Yeah, well, we're going to go see Santa and we're going Christmas shopping. And I think I'm going to get you something extra special this year.
No, no, it'll be easy.
Yeah, well, you say that every year and tell me what happens every year.
Oh, you get me something that I don't need.
And you keep it because you love me. See you guys. Bye.
What?
Faith hijacked a shipment. And now she's demanding that we pay to use our own transport routes.
Well, now she's overconfident. She needs a reality check.
Okay, this is...
AD, Lanson's here to see you.
Let him in.
Right.
Tried to disturb you at your home?
Well, you know, it's...
Look, I'm sure you're aware of this already, but Faith Roscoe is attempting to establish herself as a power in this town. I'd like for you to let her. Don't start a war.
I'm not planning to.
Sonny, you just got a second chance, all right? You got your freedom. You got a brand new baby. You got a wife who loves you. You got a family, all right? Don't throw it all away.
What is he? Do you know what he's talking about?
Okay, I know
you're
used to being involved in here. Here's how it's going to go, all right?
Jason.
If Faith dies...
Yeah.
Okay?
Uh-huh.
If she winds up disappearing, if she so much as stubs her toe, you are going to be the prime suspect, okay? I doubt you're going to get a second jury to just let you walk away clean. So do yourself a favor. Try to find a way to peacefully coexist with Faith.
I don't think Faith's interested in coexistence. She made it a point to get my face at Kelly's.
Was Courtney there?
Yeah, why?
Well, that's probably why she felt she can do that, because she's not going to retaliate with your wife standing right there.
You know Courtney's back waitressing?
Did you give her money to live on?
I didn't think about that. We got a joint bank. You know, but when you were acquitted and it turned out everything was okay with Carly, you know, I thought she might come back to me.
Okay.
But she can't deal with what happened.
Okay, you're not going to want to hear this. But it would be easier if you just let her go.
Ooh, Bobby, happen to have a piece of that world famous apple pie.
Oh, I told you we talked till too long. Santa's gone now.
He's on a coffee break. Why don't you and Letitia and Morgan go down and see the crash in front of the Queen of Angels, and when you get back, I bet you anything Santa will be back from his break.
Okay.
Have fun. What's wrong?
nothing. Why don't you go see the crash for the kids? It's really beautiful.
Okay, well, you look almost as miserable as Jason does, so why don't you tell me what's wrong?
I'm just readjusting to my new old life, you know? Waiting tables again, living upstairs, missing Jason. Come on, I know the strain that my problems put on you guys.
It's not you, Carly. It's me. Okay, I thought that I could handle Jason's work. I mean, I knew what he did. I guess I just separated it from who he was. That makes any sense.
You know, Jason is one of the best people I have ever met in my life, and that is who you fell in love with.
But then he let Sonny go off to kill Alcazar, knowing that he would either get put in prison or that he'd be killed himself. And I can't accept that, Carly. I'm not sure that I'll ever be able to.
Okay, well then, you have a choice to make. You either learn to accept the life that Jason comes with, or you say goodbye.
Listen, Courtney will hang on for a while. She'll try to accept what her heart is telling her she can't. And you can hang on with her as long as you know she can leave at any minute.
We just got married, okay? We promised to love each other for the rest of our lives.
Courtney didn't understand what this life is about. Now she's in it, she sees it, she's living it. It's not working for her.
I don't know how to give her up.
I know, it's hard. I want you both of you to be happy. But the bottom line is you're either going to have to give up on the business or give up on her.
You don't have to make any life-altering decisions today. There have been enough changes in all our lives.
Santa.
But most of them are good ones, right? And you're home again. You have a beautiful, brand new baby. Thank you again so much for taking such great care of them while I was in the hospital.
You know what?
I loved every minute of it. Michael is so wonderful. And Morgan is your little miracle.
Yeah. And maybe you're going to have your own little miracle baby. Sonny and I are proof that you do not have to have a house and a white picket fence to have a good family.
I don't know how you do it. You know, I don't always do so well, right? But for you, I don't know, you're never going to completely agree with or accept Jason's life, right? So why don't you try and just keep it separate, business and your life, you know, just love the Jason you love and then create this wonderful island just for the two of you outside all the chaos.
Hey, Carly.
Hey, Mike. Wait, it's not you?
Are you okay, honey? You seem a little distracted today.
No, I'm fine. I'm fine, I guess. Hey, Mike, I'm really glad you're here because I want to ask you a favor.
I'm sure. So.
Santa, you're back!
My hair break's over. I'm going to get back to work. Okay. Listen, you call me if you need anything, if you want to talk, because I'm here for you. Right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Hey. It's your time.
Hey.
Hey.
How'd it go, Santa?
Aw, that guy was great. They should get him every year.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Where are the boys?
Well, Mike and Letitia took him back to Mike's for an early supper. I figured we could use a little time alone.
Oh, yeah, you did?
Yeah. I've missed you.
Yeah? How much?
Well, why don't I show you how much?
Hold on.
know it was hard to think of a life without you, but it was more.
And what?
You stood in this room and you said that you'd always love me. And no matter what, your love would find its way back to me.
And here we are now.
I don't know how you got this far, but you're not going into.
I need to see Carly. She collapsed last night. Instead of leaving her in a hospital where she could get some help, Sonny brought her back here to treat her like a prisoner.
Hey! What took you so long? We've been expecting you. Come on in.
For once, your timing is impeccable. Carly and I, we just finished making love. You can go ahead and take a good look if you like. But you know what? You can declare your love for Carly again. It's not gonna matter.
This is what you want?
It's what I've always wanted. You just wouldn't hear it.
You know what, Alcazar? I'm sorry to say this, but maybe you needed to humiliate yourself to finally get the point. But now you should have it loud and clear. But just in case you don't, Carly is my wife. She doesn't belong to you, and she never will.
So Carly belongs to you? She's your possession?
Is this the life you want?
Okay, you still don't get it, Alcazar? What do we have to do here?
Maybe he needs to hear from me. When I collapsed the other day, I had another dream. I realized the truth. I realized that I love my husband and it feels right. I said it to him in the dream, and then when I woke up and I opened my eyes, I was looking into my husband's. And I didn't feel afraid. And I didn't feel disoriented, and I didn't feel disconnected. I felt exactly where I belonged. I felt loved and complete. And I don't know, whatever it was that I felt in my head for you, whatever that thing was that happened, it's gone now. I'm exactly where I belong. And I have exactly what I want, which is what I always wanted. It's to be with Sonny and the life that we made together.
So you're happy being treated like a prisoner? You enjoy his jealous rages, his paranoia?
Okay, you know, Alcazar, I mean, you heard what she just said. She just told you. I mean, give it up. Game over. You lose.
How could I love a man who deliberately tried to destroy my marriage, who paid a woman to impersonate my husband's dead wife? Look, I am already with the man that I love, and I'm not leaving him. I'm not leaving him for you, and I'm not leaving him for anyone. I want you to go now.
You heard her. And do yourself a favor. Don't come back.
You honestly believe that you've chosen love?
God, why won't he just leave us alone?
Well, you know what I think? I think he's really a sick man.
So is it all going to come to a head again? I mean, if Alcazar doesn't leave town, if he keeps pressuring me, is he going to end up dead?
Would you care if he died?
Thanks.
Oh.
Well, in a perfect world, yeah, I'd like to see Lorenzo leave town and start a new life someplace else. But I know our world is not perfect, and I know he's your enemy, and I accept that.
I am happy and grateful that we're together. Yeah. But you got to tell me, do you have any feelings for Alcazar?
Yeah, I got feelings. I am angry. I am angry for the manipulation, and I am angry.
for the deception. And there's a strange part of me that's sad, too. I'm sad for this man that I know probably could have been a better person if he had just made different choices in his life. But I don't love Lorenzo. I don't feel that for him or anything. And when he says that he loves me, I don't have any desire to go to him or be with him. I wasn't connected to him before the coma, Sonny, and I am not connected to him now. I'm connected to you. Only you. Was that okay to say to you?
And you know, what you feel is what you feel. You know, I what I want you to say to me is that you hate the man for everything he's done to us, but I guess that's my problem. What kills me is that he succeeded in what he set out to do. He almost did, you know what I mean? He came very close to having you because I let him get to me to the point where I almost killed you. Not only did I let others or pull my strings, I gave him a map to every one of them.
Sonny, we were doubting each other then, and Alcazar saw that as a way to get in, and I have no doubt anymore. I love you, and you are everything to me.
You know, there was a time that I never thought I'd hear you say those words. But we're fine.
We are more than fine.
Looks like I got off easy.
What do you mean, being acquitted of murder charges?
No. Getting over the legal system is nothing compared to getting over you. I had a game plan designed to get you back.
Really?
Yeah. I was willing to do pretty much anything to get you to fall in love with me again.
I'd play like what?
Come on, I'll show you.
Really? So, what do you think?
You look as beautiful as I knew you would.
Okay, tell me, how long has this been hanging in my closet?
Well, see, what happened was I wanted to surprise you, right? When you came home from the hospital, but we all know timing wasn't right, so I just waited.
Yeah. Is there more?
You do love surprises, huh?
Tell me what you had planned.
Well, it's like this. See, you know, after I had you in that dress, I was gonna take you to, you know, a club of your choice, go dancing, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then we were gonna fly to the Bahamas, right, and watch the sunrise and lie on the beach and hear the surf. And then when we got tired of the sand and the surf, I was gonna fly you to Manhattan and buy you the most expensive jewelry of your choice.
I wish I'd known about this, because I would have held out a lot longer.
Maybe I have to set up to making you love me more.
I don't think it's possible.
Well, at least we can work on it, right? You know, there was a moment after baby Morgan was born. Put him beside you. You were still unconscious, and I thought that it was too late, that I had lost everything, you know? And that I wouldn't be here with you ever again, dancing and just holding you close.
You brought me back.
Are you guys kissing again?
Well, we're trying, but...
No.
Yeah,
why are you guys all dressed up?
Because we're dancing, and it's one of my favorite things, huh?
Double yuck.
Double yuck? Oh, do you know that you just said the wrong thing? Do you know why? Because both of my sons are going to know how to dance.
Do I have to?
Do what your mom tells you to do.
And you're going to learn right now. So come here. Come here. Come here. Give me your hand. Now put the other one on my waist. Okay. Now just follow me. Yeah. It's good. Try not to look down, okay? See?
Yeah.
Ah, you're pretty good there. Think you're natural. Oh, yeah, you're good too. Yeah. Look at that.
Stay tuned for scenes from
the handle right now.
Well, you know, can you make sure? Because I don't want any more excuses.
All right.
What just happened?
Something I should have taken care of a long time ago.
We finally have everything we could want. We can't risk losing that, honey.
I agree. That call wasn't about business. I'm making plans for it. Morgan has not been christened yet, right? Now, I know traditionally the ceremony comes a month after the baby's born, but I wanted to wait till you were better.
I would love to have Morgan baptized, but it's so close to Christmas, we're not going to be able to book a church.
Okay, well, Father Coates is making an exception. We're going to meet him in a few hours.
What about Mike and Bobby?
They'll be there.
You thought of everything.
Our son deserved this, Carly. I'm not going to let anyone take this day from us.
Morgan's christening is today, and I know that things have been a little strained between you and Courtney, so
I just have to say this. Being Morgan's godmother is so important to Courtney. She should be the one at church. I'm going to stay away.
If I go to church today, you know, I'll be swearing to help Morgan through the rest of his life.
Well, you already have. Being a godparent, it's a promise, you know, that you'll take care of Morgan just in case something happens to me or Carly.
Yeah, I know. Right. And Jason will take that promise very seriously.
Okay.
You know, he's everything he says today, he's kind of mean from his heart. He'll swear to protect and love Morgan and teach him right from wrong, and then he's going to go off to his job, and I don't understand that.
Are you saying Jason shouldn't be a godparent?
No, of course not. No, not at all. He'll give Morgan the best of himself. He will.
Right.
I'm the one with the problem. You know, I can't reconcile the two worlds that Jason lives in. And the last thing I want is for Jason to think that I'm judging him on the day that Morgan's baptized.
Listen to you. You love Jason. No matter what happens to your marriage, both of you are going to be part of Morgan's life.
My dream is that Morgan will be like you. Strong and honest and fair. Not to mention willing to put up with me. Come on, Jason. We named him to honor you, just like you named Michael to honor Sonny.
I know you did. And I promise you that I will be a good godfather whether I'm at that ceremony or not.
No, you have to be at the ceremony. So does Courtney. She devoted herself to Morgan after my accident. And aside from my mother, I wouldn't trust my sons with anyone else. Because as long as the two of you are in their lives, I know that they will be safe and they will be loved.
I don't need the ceremony to love Morgan.
I know that. Okay, and I know you were trying to do the right thing. But Courtney wouldn't want you to stay away. And Morgan needs both of you to be there. Please, Jason, please. Will you just stand up for my son?
Hey, Stone, how you doing? My son's being baptized today. We named him Morgan Stone Corinthos after you and Jason. And one day when he comes to me, because he's facing some difficulty or he thinks he can't handle something, I'm gonna tell him all about you. Because I've never known anybody the courage to handle the disease the way you did. So say a little prayer for my little boy. I know with you watching over him, he's gonna grow up someday to be good and brave, just like you. Amen.
Sonny? Are we interrupting?
No. I was just talking to an old friend.
Have the godparents arrived yet?
I gotta talk.
Hey, sorry we're late. Thank you for coming.
Are we ready for this?
Hey, doesn't Morgan look handsome?
She's in a dress.
No, Michael, it's a gown.
Still looks funny to me.
Well, you know, you were wearing the same thing the day you were christened. Except your hair was a little lighter.
Yeah. Sounds better.
Shall we get started?
Yeah, let's get this ready going.
Dearest Father in heaven, bless this day of new beginnings. Smile upon Morgan Stone Corinthos and surround him with the mantle of your love. As we welcome Morgan into the family of your church and the light of your redemption, bless also those surrounding Morgan, his mother and father, brother, godparents, grandparents, and all those who love him. Grant that they may teach and guide Morgan to a strong and abiding faith in you, O Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Jason and Courtney Morgan, you have come here today as this child's godparents to present him for the sacrament of baptism. It will be your constant care to bring him up in the practice of the faith and to see that the life God gives him is kept safe from sin. If your own faith makes you ready to accept this responsibility, please renew the vows of your own baptism. Do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children?
We do.
We do.
Do you reject evil and refuse to be mastered by it?
We do.
It's okay, buddy. It's
okay. Heavenly Father, you have blessed this child. Teach him to follow in your footsteps and live in the way of love, faith, and charity. Amen.
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 Good job.
It's okay.
I guess things are still pretty rough between you and Jason, huh?
Was it that obvious?
No. You never were good at hiding things.
I'm miserable, Dad.
But I want you to listen to me. I'm very proud of you, Courtney. Morgan couldn't ask for better godparents. And I know that even though you're going through a rough patch right now, you and Jason are going to fight for each other. Someday, you'll be at your own child's christening.
Dad, you know...
Listen, I don't care what the doctors say. Miracles happen, honey. I mean, look at today. We are here together. This family is finally happy. And very soon, you're gonna be happy too.
To show my gratitude for the special arrangements you made to baptize Morgan today.
It's always our pleasure to welcome a new parishioner through baptism.
Well, you know what? If there's ever Anything else you need, you know.
Well, tomorrow is our annual Christmas party for the kids who are less fortunate. For most of them, the gift they receive here will be the only one that they get.
You want
for
me
Christmas.
To provide the gifts?
No, they've already been donated. Unfortunately, our transportation arrangements have fallen through. The truck that was donated broke down, and...
Well, Jay, you can handle that, right?
Yeah, we can take care of that.
Mm.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. The kids are going to be so happy.
Oh, I am never, ever going to forget this day.
Mm. Yeah, it was good.
Yeah.
All right.
How great was it? Having Jason and Courtney stand up for Morgan. Oh, do you see the way they looked at each other? They were so sweet. They're not. Mm-mm.
Don't you stay out of it.
No, they're getting back together. What do you mean? You meddle?
No, I never meddle.
Oh, please. How about when you had Jason make sure that the parish got toys? You said it just loud enough so Courtney would hear. And then she was just about to melt when he said he'd make sure they got delivered. They're gonna be okay. Just like us.
Just like us. What did Dr. Lewis say?
Everything seems normal. But I am still healing, so he said we could be in for a few more surprises.
I want to talk to the doctor.
Okay. Go ahead, but I'm sure he's going to tell you the same thing. Look, there may be some more problems, but there's really not necessarily going to be any warning signs, and there's nothing we can do about
it. Warning? What kind of problems?
Will you stop? Please. Let's focus on the good things. We have two beautiful, healthy sons. It's Morgan's first Christmas, and you know, we are lucky to be able to share Christmas at all. We've been given so much, so let's just enjoy it. Okay, we have a family. Let's be happy.
You're right.
Where's Michael?
He ate a plate of French fries and a half a bottle of ketchup.
Mm. So he's crashing?
Yeah, he's upstairs in my room. Mm. So how did the checkup go?
I'm healing. There may be some side effects. There may not, but there's really nothing to worry about. Hey, what are you going to wear tonight to the party?
Did Carly just change the subject?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. Mm. Why don't you just come on over and then we can all go together?
I can't. I'm working a double shift.
Okay, Jason went all that way to get the toys.
Yeah, I'm not even sure if Jason's gonna make it, you know? There's this huge storm coming in, and besides, I've already promised Bobby.
Okay, you know that my mom would rather close Kelly's for the night than to have you miss a little party where all these adorable little kids are gonna be.
Hello?
Mr. Corinthos.
Who gave you this number?
I have something you want. Meet me at Pier 17 as soon as possible.
No, you don't summon me to meetings.
Well, I'd suggest you send Jason, but he's, a little tied up.
Yeah, I gotta be someplace.
Did something happen to Jason? How was dinner?
I'm short $2.
Oh, it's no problem, really.
Hey, we're good for the money, I promise.
How about we seal the deal with a cookie? May I give your daughter one?
Yeah, okay, that'd be great.
How about chocolate chip? Here you go.
What do you say?
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome.
Wait. Have you heard from Sonny?
No, and I doubt I will. It's business.
What if something happened to Jason, though?
Jason's pretty good at taking care of himself.
You're right. I'm selfish to even worry.
Yeah.
Look at that woman with the kids. She has real problems.
Look at all we have. So give yourself a break. Come to the party.
If Jason shows up, I don't know. I mean, if he doesn't, I'll be worried the whole night. If he does, I'll just be missing him and thinking about the last Christmas we spent together and all the ones that we're not gonna have. I think it's just easier on both of us if I just turn my back and walk away.
Well, I see you've brought all of your people. And they're busy watching all of my people. Puts me right into the holiday spirit.
What do you want, Faith?
Respect, Mr. Corinthos.
You don't deserve it.
Well, would you like to explain that to Jason before I kill him or after? Love isn't enough.
So what is the alternative? Do you really think that you and Jason are better off apart? Because I don't know. I know him pretty well, and he's miserable right now.
Yeah, well, so am I.
So the solution is to go home.
I don't want to judge Jason, Carly, and that's what I do. Okay, he let Sonny, your husband, my brother, Michael, and Morgan's father, walk out of the house with a loaded gun. Jason knew that Sonny was going to commit murder, and he didn't do anything.
Yeah, well, it's not what happened, okay?
It's not Jason's fault that he sees the world the way he does, but I don't.
Well, isn't it possible to agree to disagree? I mean, love doesn't mean that you can control someone, how they are or what they think, and trust me, I know that. But we still loved each other. And love, it goes beyond fear and control, and love is what helped me get back to Sonny. Love is, it's everything. Everything just takes care of itself if you have that.
I tried to believe that, Carly, but I can't anymore. Too much has happened.
Okay. I realize I'm a little bit biased here because you and Jason are my best friends, and I just happen to think you're perfect together.
But that's just it. We're not. What good is all the love in the world if Jason and I can't live together?
Well, why can't you? Who says you can't? I'm not making light of the differences between you and Jason, but I mean, is this really what you want to do? Do you really want to walk away from someone you still love and someone who loves you as well?
Maybe this is impossible for anyone to understand, but I love Jason too much to stay. Jason was in my territory.
It's a free travel zone.
Not anymore.
How'd you know about the shipment?
I have my ways.
Do you have any idea what we're moving?
Who cares? If you're working in this weather, you must be desperate.
I'm dealing with some tough customers.
Well, send them my apologies. Now, the crate is proof of possession. The rest of the crates and the truck are locked up. Shipment is mine.
I understand.
But in the spirit of the holidays, I'm willing to offer you a deal. If you agree not to retaliate, I will give you Jason back. As is. Isn't that good of me?
You drive a hard bargain.
I don't have all night.
Okay.
Okay, what?
I won't retaliate.
Now, is that so difficult?
My customers aren't going to be very happy.
Well, tell them to give me a call. Maybe we can work something out.
All right. Jason, do you have any idea, any idea how to get a hold of Santa Claus?
I don't know if he has a cell phone or not.
Are you guys trying to be funny? What is inside?
Nothing.
You know we don't move drugs, Faith.
You can hide all sorts of things in a doll.
You're not going to find anything in there, Faith.
Don't be so sure.
We are shipping toys to Father Coates, where there's a party tonight at the Queen of Angels. So those gifts are the only presents these kids are going to get.
Really?
Yeah, really.
Well, God bless them, everyone. Get this stuff out of here.
Now, I want you to get the rest of your people out of here, too, because we have some business to discuss. Just you and me.
But you need to get him out of here.
I'm not going.
You shouldn't worry about Faith. You should find yourself another job, Xander.
I'll be fine.
Okay. You guys go ahead and go on. You guys take care of him. You say you want my respect?
Almost as much as I want your territory.
Yeah? You're not gonna have either, you know why? Because you're sloppy, you don't know what you're doing, and the thing that I just don't like the most is that you're arrogant.
Tell that to the five families.
Okay, you know what? You might want to step aside because, you know, I don't know. Who knows who might fall in that water, you know what I mean?
Tina!
Not you, right?
Get back here, Tina! Have you seen a little girl? She got away from me at Kelly's. She runs and she doesn't think.
What? Whoa. Don't.
Oh.
There you go. Your mommy's right here.
What were you thinking? Oh, you saved my baby.
All right.
How can I pay you back?
Don't worry about it.
Hey, what took you so long? I was worried. Where's Jason?
He's fine. I'm fine. Everything's good. Look, I just need to apologize for Father Colt. It's about the toys.
Why? They came 10 minutes ago.
Oh.
Come on. See?
Hi, Daddy.
Hey, you doing good work there, buddy?
Yep.
Merry Christmas, Sonny.
Yeah, you too, Father.
I'm gonna get you some punch.
All right.
Okay. Yeah.
Good thing for once.
What can I say? It's Christmas. And I know what it's like to have a lousy child. Thank you, Mr. Quintus.
No problem.
I saw those people at Kelly's. Do you know them?
In a way.
Yeah? So where did they get their new coats?
You asked too many questions.
Merry Christmas.
What do you say?
Thank you.
We have a good life. I think I'm ready to enjoy it.
So am I.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Why don't you just read me the note?
And it smells delicious.
Well, you're gonna find out. You just thank me for not allowing Mike to cook for us.
Why? Mike's an excellent cook.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Compared to who?
Sorry.
Where's Michael, by the way?
Michael.
Yeah, your son?
Oh, right. He's on a secret mission.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
What kind of secret mission?
Well, you'll find out.
And Courtney?
Hey, so...
Yes.
How you doing?
I'm good. How you doing?
Are you going to tell me about that secret mission, or what are you going to do?
You really want to know?
Well, the suspense is killing. Yeah.
Well, it's a surprise. So,
really?
Yeah, I can't tell you.
Really?
Really.
Are you sure about that? Just tell me about the secret mission.
You gonna torture me or something?
If you call this torture, look. See that? Right here.
All right, Max. No, thanks a lot, buddy. I got it. Merry Christmas.
This guy.
Who?
Craig.
Hi. Hey, look, I know I should have knocked first, but anyway, it's good to see you two together. Yeah. Michael!
Hey, Mike. Huh? Michael's on a top secret mission.
Top secret mission? Do I get to know what the mission is?
Well, Carly's not talking, but I'm working on it.
Oh, well, don't let me interrupt. I got some Christmas cookies and a fruit cake that's actually edible. I will take these to the kitchen, all right? All right? Yeah. Carry on. Okay. Carry on.
So, yes. What I was going to ask you something.
What do you need to know?
So, can you just, like, tell me what my point is?
You're going to have to work harder than that.
Hey.
Sweetie.
Tell me about that top secret mission, will you?
I guess that would be me. Hey, Maker. Hi.
Hey.
Really good surprise, huh, Daddy?
The best. So are you staying for dinner?
Yeah, and I brought my overnight bag so I could be here Christmas morning, if that's okay.
I was hoping you'd come, yeah. How did you talk her into this?
I asked.
Yeah, in a very persuasive way.
Wow. Good job, buddy. Listen, Merry Christmas. That's a great gift for me.
I'm sorry. Okay. I'm sorry. I don't know where my mind is. God. Jason, maybe? Leave it. What's up? I was thinking about last Christmas Eve. You know, Jason and I were together living in our loft, and it was amazing, Carly. I mean, it was like our own little oasis where we could shut out the rest of the world. You know, and Jason was supposed to spend the night in lockup, and I thought I'd be alone, and he showed up, you know, before midnight, and I have never been so happy to see anyone in my whole life. If someone had told me that a year later Jason and I would already be married and separated, I wouldn't have believed him.
All right, you just tell me something, all right? I mean, can you imagine your life loving Jason forever and never ever being with him again?
No. Okay, so what are you waiting for? Work this out. Carly, even if Jason walked through the door right now, it wouldn't change anything.
Oh, really, wouldn't it?
This was just delivered from Michael.
Oh, yeah? Who's it from?
Jason.
Thanks, Max.
Time to check the meal. Wow.
It's a telescope.
Wow, look how beautiful that is.
Oh, sweet, there's a card. Here.
It's big.
Can we read it?
Yeah. Can we help put that together or what? No?
To my
exploring
buddy, the moon and the stars, Uncle Jason.
Oh, man.
That's great.
Hey, can I call Uncle Jason and tell him thank you for the telescope?
Sure you can.
Cool.
Have a seat, Wanda. You get way too... There, say hi, hurry.
Hi, Uncle Jason, it's me. Thank you for the telescope, it's really good. When are you coming home? Okay. You gotta show me how to use it. Yeah, everyone's here. Okay.
What?
Uncle Jason wants to talk to you, Dad.
Oh, hey, what's going on? No, we're just here, you know, Mike's opening up presents. Mike, the other Mike is trying to cook. Yeah. All right, here's Carly.
Merry Christmas. Hello. Hey, Jason.
He knows where I'm walking.
How you doing? Yeah, we wish you were here. You know, that present I got you, it is under the tree. And yeah, well, it's called being gracious, good manners, you know. Courtney's here. You want to speak to her? Merry Christmas, Jason. Bye.
But
he didn't think you'd want to talk to him. That's all.
The Christmas feast is ready.
Ooh. Okay.
I do.
Out off the grill.
Glazed ham. I have been waiting for this all day long.
It looks really beautiful, Sonny. I'm impressed.
Well, you know.
Yeah, you should wait until you taste his sweet potatoes with marshmallows. It's like you've died and gone to heaven.
Okay. I admit it. No one cooks a better holiday meal than you, Sonny. Although my recipe for the cornbread would have been the crowning touch.
Of course, yours is the best, right? Right.
Okay, can we stop all the talking and just dig on in?
Yeah, well, first I want to, it'd be nice to say, you know, Grace, what about you, buddy? You think maybe you want to do the honors?
Yeah, okay.
Think so? All right.
God is gracious, God is good. We must thank him for this food. Amen.
Amen.
That's good.
God, I want to thank you for some other people, too. I want to thank you for my daddy being all right, my mommy being back, my little baby brother. Oh, and one more thing, God. Can you please make my Uncle Jason and Aunt Courtney happy again? Amen.
Amen. All right, well, now.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to
you. I got 38,000 points.
What?
Hey, guys.
Wow, you look beautiful.
All you guys ever do is hug.
I got another present for you.
Really?
Yeah, I've been saving it for tonight.
Do I get it now?
Close your eyes.
Yeah, okay.
All right,
they're closed.
Help your mother,
hello.
Help your mother walk a little bit here. Yeah.
Don't peek.
Okay, I won't.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Open your eyes.
Oh.
Oh, I don't get to be stunned. Is that it?
Well, you usually have a bigger reaction to jewelry. Oh. You know what I mean?
Okay, the necklace, it is gorgeous. Okay, I was so shocked I couldn't speak.
I guess that's the part I didn't believe.
Stop. Are you being sick again?
No, honey, I'm not. Okay, I love this necklace. And I love your daddy, and I love you, and I love Morgan and everything. It's fine. Okay? Will you please just go upstairs, tell Letitia that we're not gonna be late, all right?
Okay.
Wait. And stop playing with the thing all night, you know.
Okay.
All right? That toy is like a...
You got it for him.
I know I did. I cannot wait to show you off tonight.
Yeah, now that I'm not pregnant.
Oh, I loved it when you were pregnant.
So the last time we were at a major event was what? Was it the cellar?
Way too long. And just so you know, Luke's going to be inviting a lot of high rollers tonight, and that includes Hakazar.
Well, you think he'd bother to show up?
I hope he does. Because I want him to see you looking beautiful and happy. See us on the dance floor like nobody else is around. Hakazar needs to know he can't touch us. Not in a dream. Not in reality. He needs to realize he will never, ever have you. That's why I haven't killed him.
Hey, welcome home.
Thanks.
I missed you.
Missed you too. Casino's had a great Christmas.
Oh, thanks for taking care of that.
You look very, very handsome.
Don't start.
What? It's such a waste. Being all dressed up, going to the party by yourself.
No, I hate parties. I'm only going out of respect for Luke.
Well, you can respect Luke all you want. It doesn't mean you can't enjoy yourself. I think you should call Courtney and we can all go together as a family.
Courtney and I aren't together, Carly.
Well, she was miserable at Christmas.
Well, the marriage is over.
Is that what she wants? Did she say those words?
We decided
Jason?
Together, yes.
Yeah, Carly, you know what? It's just, you should leave this one alone now.
Don't you see what's happening?
Yeah, but...
Come on, you and Courtney, you love each other. And for some reason, you have convinced yourselves that the best thing
Carly,
for you is to let
Carly,
go.
I
and I think if one of you
can't do this,
out,
okay? I mean it. Courtney and I aren't together. Just let it go.
Carly!
Hi!
Hello! Hey. You look so gorgeous.
Oh, so do you. Sonny,
you provided the final touches.
Oh, Sonny, I love it. Well, you obviously had a very Merry Christmas, didn't you?
Yeah, we did.
That was good to see you two out together again.
Mr. Corinthos and family, I'm honored. Welcome to my new club.
Are you the hostess?
You know, I still don't understand. If the Cassadines are so penniless, how'd you afford to buy that rock?
Yeah, love always finds a way, so...
I'm opening the tables.
It's too early.
Well, how do you plan to pay for all these free drinks? Not out of my cut, if that's
what
you're thinking.
I haven't even welcomed the guests
yet. Well, then
yet.
I will do the opening remarks.
I thought you were supposed to be the silent partner.
Yeah, you wouldn't have this place if it weren't for me.
The operative word being silent. Stay out of my way.
Moments of your time. Thank you.
Well, welcome to the Haunted Star. Is everyone having a good time? Wonderful, very good. My business partner, Luke Spencer, always dreamed of turning this ship into a casino. And now we have. Unfortunately, though, Luke couldn't be here this evening, but he did just call in to say that he hopes that you spend lots of money, have a great time, come back tomorrow with cash. I'm sure some of you here do know about the authentic Wild Bill Hickok's Dead Man's Hand. We do have that here on display for the guests to enjoy, to look at, and we hope that it brings you luck. It already has brought us much luck. And just as the Dead Man's Hand has found a home here, we hope that you all feel at home here on the Haunted Star. Okay. So, we wish you a wonderful evening, tons of luck, and, well, let the games begin! What was that? A cannon? We must be officially welcomed into the harbor.
Is this vessel safe?
We're tied to the pier, Edward.
If we start taking on water, it shouldn't be too hard to evacuate.
Well, that was probably a stunt of Spencer's.
Maybe this boat really is haunted. Question is, by whom?
Courage.
May Cody bring the treasure safely to the surface.
Pick a number?
Yes. Seven red.
Sounds lucky to me.
Well.
Want to play again?
Why not? Courtney! Say! Hey, can we disappear in the crowd for a while? I really can't handle a family interrogation at the moment.
Invasiveness is my strong suit.
No, I love him.
Okay, well, Courtney is obviously heartbroken. There's no other reason she would be out with a cop.
Jason asked you to leave alone.
Well, Jason is miserable. So is your sister. Is that what you want for them?
She doesn't even know that he's here.
Well, she's about to find out.
I am better at blackjack. My mom taught me how to play.
Well, maybe you should give up waitressing and become a professional gambler.
So, have you won anything yet? Hi, Carly.
Hi.
Think that I don't know you're avoiding me? Brian, meet my sister-in-law, Carly Corinthos.
Yeah, we met. You're the cop that shot my husband.
That was a tough night for us all. I hope we can get past it.
Yeah, have you seen Jason? Since he got back?
No. Here, tonight.
Jason, he hates parties, Carly. Yeah, well, maybe you should try gambling with Jason, because, you know,
he's got amazing luck. It's probably because it doesn't matter if he wins or not.
I'm sorry, but this was a bad idea.
Of course.
Oh, don't hit me.
Enjoying yourself, Mr. Corinthos?
Do you have to remind me that you're still here?
I liked you so much better when you were retired.
Gets hurt. Come on. Rings, wallets, cash. Get up. Come on. Bracelet two. Watch, buddy. Sorry, Mr. Quintus. I didn't know you were here. Keep your stuff. Let's go. Watch. Rings, wallets, come on. Okay, let's go. Come on.
Thank you.
on, the ring too.
But it's my wedding ring, please. I just got married. Okay, okay.
Hey, get your hands off me! Everybody get down! Anybody who leaves here is gonna end up in a body bag.
Bastards. I like that bracelet.
Well, Faithy, why don't you run after him?
Are you okay?
Yeah, are you?
No, I'm fine. I'm fine, as long as you're okay. Sonny.
Please, please, spared your watch. I don't have time right now. I gotta find my wife.
Sonny. Oh, my God.
I was looking for you. Where'd you go?
I went onto the deck and one of the robbers cornered me.
What'd he do?
Somebody's been shot!
Stay inside.
That must be the guy who cornered me.
He's dead. Anybody know this guy? I've never seen him before in my life.
Me neither.
Well, who the hell killed him?
I did.
Deck for some fresh air. When I turned the corner, this guy jumped me, pointed a gun at me, and demanded my watch, which I gave him. I said I don't like having things stolen from me. So, when he lowered his gun, I jumped him, and just then, two or three more guys came out, holding a small bag, and that's when the gun went off.
In the struggle?
Yeah, that's right.
Hey, get away from the stiff.
Yeah, as soon as I retrieve my watch.
Lansing, get him in here and get a statement.
Come on, let's go. I'm glad you're all right.
Hey, you know, Sonny, it's kind of funny. Everybody in the casino was robbed, except for you. In fact, those thugs, they practically bowed at your feet.
Maybe they were intimidated.
I doubt that. I think that Faith Roscoe didn't cut you into the action, so you muscled your way in. Sure, who's boss, right? I'm sure if I do a little looking into this robbery, it's gonna lead right to your door.
You know what, Scott? I own several offshore casinos. I have no interest in acquiring another one.
I don't believe in anything you say, Corentos. I think this is the first step in your takeover of the casino.
A bunch of thugs holding up a room full of missing people? It's not my style, Scotty.
The only style you got came from your tailor, Corentos.
I've given my statement. I assume I'm free to leave.
Well, I may need you to come downtown, answer a few questions.
Fine. Not everything to hide.
Of course, everybody here, innocent as lambs.
Baldwin was wondering why I was overlooked in the robbery, and I'm just wondering why you weren't.
Not sure what that means.
Yeah, interesting.
Ian?
Yeah?
He took the necklace that you gave me.
Oh, really?
He touched my necklace. He ran his hand up my cheek.
Then what?
He kissed me.
What?
I pushed him away, and then he grabbed the necklace. He ripped it off of me, and he ran. That's when I came back inside.
So you suppose he just ran into Alcazar?
What he said? He said then he shot him. I don't know. I'm supposed to be grateful, I guess.
Okay, I'm just reaching here, but This whole thing had been set up. And the man who kissed you was Alcazar? All right, let's think about this sick man who kissed you. Is there anything you can identify? His eyes, you know, his cologne, his hands, anything? I mean...
No,
what's wrong? Huh?
I don't know.
Does your head hurt?
Yeah.
Is this the first time?
No.
It's all right.
It's like a flash of light, you know, like when you stand up too fast.
You had pain.
Yeah, I did, but I'm fine.
How many times has this happened before?
I don't know.
I'm gonna take you to the hospital.
Sonny, please, let's not make a big deal.
No, I'm not gonna make a big deal. I know it's probably nothing, but Dr. Lewis said because of the head injuries, you know, things would happen. So I want to find out what's going on.
It's all good. Tests show no abnormalities. If the headaches return and you see any more flashes of light, let us know.
Okay. Thank you.
Whew. All right.
See, I told you. There's nothing to worry about.
Yeah, I know, but you could never be too sure. You know? All right, I'm going to get dressed, huh?
Truth is, we know very little about the kind of brain damage Carly sustained.
But it should just go away, right?
It's possible, but the episodes could turn into something more severe.
Well, why don't I just leave her in the hospital? I mean, I don't want her to have a seizure or something. You know,
No. We wouldn't let her go home if we thought there was a chance of major complications. I'm just saying that there could be changes in her condition.
Well, what should I be looking for?
We just... I have to wait and see how she does in the coming months.
Okay. Thanks, Doc.
Sure.
Hey, I'm ready. Let's go home. Do you feel like the...
So, I had Letitia take the boys to the park so you could have some, you know, quiet time.
You don't have to coddle me. Dr. Well, Lewis said everything was fine.
Yeah, I know.
What?
Meyer called. He said it's important that you get back to him as soon as possible.
All right.
Because I'll be going out of town for a few days.
Yeah, do you have to make the call right now?
Yeah, why?
There's something really important that needs your immediate attention. And you sort that mail, and I don't know, all of a sudden I just had to have your hands on me.
Really? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What are you doing?
Come here.
Mm-hmm.
to you is... Well, let's just say I am the luckiest woman in the world.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. Not bad yourself.
Oh. Ah, seriously, Sonny, that was amazing.
Kind of reminded me of the first time we were together.
Yeah, I couldn't help myself then either.
It's been a while since we were like this.
You've been so careful with me since I got home from the hospital.
I just figured you needed some time, you know?
Well, it feels good to reconnect. Mentally. Physically. And in our hearts.
Wow, he's...
Bit of a flash.
Unreal, like before the thing?
No. This, it was, It was like a fantasy.
Really?
Yeah, you were touching me and kissing me. Here.
Mm-hmm. Where?
Here.
Like where?
In there. Bother putting that on again. Want to know why?
What?
Because it's gonna come off.
No, again. I get. Listen to me. I gotta make some business calls. Seriously.
You mean?
Yeah.
All right. I help you with your shirt.
That's nice. Thank
I'm
you.
Nice. I'm very, very.
Oh, okay. See, now you always have to move.
Yeah.
Sorry, Vic.
Okay.
Meyer called again. All right. Listen. Call him. No, tell him I want to handle this personally. Call the pilot. Tell him to be ready in an hour. I'm ready to leave.
You got it, Mr. Corinthos.
All right.
You're going on the business trip.
Yeah, I've been putting it off for months, but I got to take care of it. You got my shirt?
What?
Come on.
Do you really have to leave?
It's hopefully it won't be for very long, but I tell you what. Anything happens... I'm serious about this, you know. Jason's across the hall. He'll take you to the hospital, whatever you need.
I don't want you to leave.
You're not sick, are you?
No.
You feeling good?
Yeah. It's just that I've missed you. We haven't had enough time together yet.
I know. Hey, guess what? Listen to me. Just think of how great the reunion is going to be.
Mm. Oh, that might